morning, friends, and welcome to Ramblin' with Red Yarn. Are y'all ready to ramble? Well, I couldn't quite hear you. You're going to have to speak up. Are you ready to ramble? Good. Let's get rambling. Here we go. I may be taken to the deep woods, where the critters make me feel good. I may be taken walking down on the farm, and do some dancing in the old barn. Oh, maybe take me around this town, backyard to the playground. Or maybe we can take a gamble, and maybe we can go rambling. Oh, I'm gonna take you rambling, farm to the forest, fast as a hare, slow as a tortoise, scrambling, briars and brambles, ambling, longing to explore this land, and enter back home to our families. Welcome to Ramblin' with Red Yarn. Hey, did y'all like that little animation we showed? Isn't that cool? That's a little map of Red Yarn's world. My buddy Ryan Bruce, who's an amazing illustrator and artist and has helped me with a lot of projects, he drew that cool map. And then my buddy Dave Gulick, who is a fellow musician, he performs in a band called Ants, 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 who you should check out. He helped with that little animation. So let's give a big round of applause to Ryan and Dave for helping out. It's so fun to get to let y'all see the little world we're rambling through today. How's everybody doing out there? Good. Show me on your thumbs. Kiddos, how are you feeling today? You feeling pretty good? You feeling really good? You feeling super excited to be together? Is anybody feeling just kind of so-so? Or even a little bit grumpy or sleepy or sad today? Hey, it's okay to feel all those ways, you know. But it is good to have some ways to cheer yourself up and have a little fun together. Would y'all like to have some fun together? Good. How much fun do you think we should have? Like this much? More than that? Like this much? More than that? Like this much? More than that? Stretch out your arms and show me how much fun you want to have. You want to have that much fun? That is so much fun. Well, I'm going to need your help if we're going to have that much fun this morning. Who remembers? How do we have fun when old Red Yarn, that's me, and my critters come around? What do we like doing for fun? First, we love singing together. Put one finger up in the air like this if you love singing like I do. Well, good. Let's warm up our singing voices. Everybody take a big deep breath. And sing la 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 la. Ooh, beautiful. Put two fingers up like this if you like dancing too. Nice. Let's warm up our dance moves with a little wiggle in our seats. Awesome. Raise one hand if you like animals. Oh, good, because I brought some critters and they can't wait to see you. And raise both your hands like this and stick out your tongue like this and go, if you want to get a little silly. Should we get a little silly? I think that's a great idea. Well, friends, before we get started, let's sing a little good morning song called Beautiful Day. Can you make a little sun in front of you like this? All right, try singing this with me. Sing. The sun has come up, the rooster has crowed, and I'm wide awake from my head to my toes. My friends are all here. We're ready to play. A good morning to you. It's a beautiful day. Yay! It is a beautiful day. And I'm so glad you're all here this morning. In a little bit, I'll shout out to see who's watching. So if you haven't had a chance, have your grown-up type in your name so I know you're watching today. And I'll say hi in a little bit. But first, let's say hi to a critter. What do you think? Would that be fun? Yeah, I think that's a great idea. Let's see which of my critters came along today. It's my friend Miss Molly Cottontail. Y'all remember Miss Molly? Oh, Miss Molly's the best. Let's see how Miss Molly's doing today. Everybody call her out in a big voice. Say, come on out, Miss Molly. Come on out, Miss Molly.
Here I am. Hi, everybody. It's me, Miss Molly.
Say hi, Miss Molly.
Hi.
Miss Molly, what's the matter? You sound a little bit upset this morning.
Well, I'm feeling a little bit annoyed and frustrated and mad today.
Why are you feeling annoyed and frustrated and mad?
Well, I'm feeling mad at my big brother, Bob Rabbit.
Why are you mad at your big brother, Bob?
Well, because it's just not fair, Red Yarn. You see, we've been trying to grow this garden right here, right? And So over the summer, me and my friend Gracie the groundhog, we did all this work. We got the soil ready, we planted the seeds, we watered, and we weeded, and what did my big brother Bob do? Nothing. He just watched us. And we did all this work all through the summer, weeding, watering, tending the garden. And then when the vegetables had grown really big, we harvested the vegetables. And guess what Bob did? Nothing. He just watched us as me and Gracie picked all the vegetables. And then we cooked a big harvest feast. Me and Gracie, we made boiled cabbage and salad and stew. And guess what Bob did? Nothing. He just sat there and watched. But when it was time to eat the feast, guess what Bob did?
What did Bob do?
He wanted to eat the whole thing, and he didn't even do any of the work. It was not fair. I was so frustrated.
Oh, that sounds frustrating. Does that sound fair to y'all? That Bob Rabbit didn't do any of the helping and didn't pitch in, but he still wanted to eat the big feast? Nah, that doesn't seem very fair. Well, what did you say to Bob Rabbit?
Well, I said, you're my brother, and I love you, and I want to share so you can eat some of the food. But next time, Bob Rabbit, you need to help. You need to do your part.
I agree. It would be much better if Bob Rabbit had done his part. But you know what, Miss Molly?
What?
It was really generous of you to share with him anyways.
Well, it seemed like the right thing to do.
But what do y'all think? Raise your hand if you think it's important to do your part. Yep. To pitch in. To make sure that you're doing your fair part if you're going to benefit from something like that.
Well, I agree. So, next time I'll remind Bob, hey, if you're going to enjoy that feast, you got to chip in and do your part.
Hey, let's sing a song about the first time you and Bob and Gracie ever came to my garden.
Oh, I love that song. That sounds like a great plan. Hey, it was great to see y'all today. Thanks for helping me talk through that. I'll see you soon. Bye.
Say bye, Miss Molly.
Bye.
All right. It's important to be fair. It's important to do your part in your family, with your friends, in your community, paying your taxes, whatever it may be. It's important that everybody does their fair share, right? So this song is called Critters in My Garden. And if you want to dance, you can. Kiddos, stand your bodies up and let's get ready to move a little bit. Here's how it goes. Oh, there's some critters in my garden and I want them to get out. I got some starters starting and I got some veggie sprouts. I've got a guard dog garden, but he's a lazy lout. Critters, I beg your pardon, but you really must stay out. Everybody hop like a rabbit. First the rabbits came a-hopping. Toes, sneak in, wiggle under that little hole in the fence, creep over to the garden, find your favorite fruit or vegetable, start munching on it, digging it up, yum, yum, yum. Oh no, here comes the gardener, everybody run away, ah! Alright, so here's what I did with those critters. So I held a public meeting for to set those critters straight, and soon they all came streaming. Great. garden. Friends, guess what? Tomorrow, on Wednesday, I'm releasing the first episode of Red Yarn's Backyard, my new web series. A few weeks ago, I released the intro and theme song, but tomorrow is episode one, and it's a music video for Critters in My Garden. It's a story about the first time the critters ever came to Red Yarn's Backyard. It's a really funny video, so be on the lookout. I'm gonna release it on YouTube tomorrow, okay? I hope you check it out. Hey, let's see who all's here this morning. Let's see who all's watching. Eliza says hi. Hi, Eliza. My friend Colette's watching. She said, what's happening, Red Yarn? How are you? I'm doing pretty good, Colette. Thanks for asking. How are you doing? I had a nice weekend. I hope you did too. Let's see, Finn and Max are here. Hi, Finn and Max. Oliver and Arlo are watching. Hi, friends. Ava and Maddie say hello this morning. Hi, Ava and Maddie. Another Ava and her mommy are watching too. Good morning, other Ava. Cascadia's watching with her dad, Patch. Rosie's watching. Connolly and Payson are here. The Coopers in Oklahoma, Nora and Zoe are ready to rock out. And Rylan and Owen are watching. Ooh, and they're part of my preschool, I'm part of their preschool routine on Tuesday and Thursday. I'm music class. Woohoo! Glad to hear it. I'm glad I get to be your music class, Owen and Rylan. Buggy says, hi, Red Yarn. Miranda and Winona are watching. Finn and Leaf are watching. And Finn wants to tell me that he and Leaf play a game with a globe. That's a really cool thing to play with, Finn. Thanks for letting me know. Anna says, gorgeous animation. Thanks, Ryan and Dave. Yeah, thank you, Anna. Hattie's watching. And she says, she has something funny to say. She said, I used to have her dog, and her name was Maudie Lou. Aw, that's such a sweet doggie. Do you miss Maudie Lou, Hattie? Thanks for telling me about Maudie Lou. Alexander's watching. Beth and family are watching. Chaiton is watching today. Oscar and Otto are here. Scout and Rave are here. Raven and Scout are here. Oh, sorry. That Scout and Raven are watching. Ava would like to know about the red thing on my guitar. I'll tell you about that in a minute. JW and Beth, Finn and Leaf, Elliot and Clive. Oh my goodness, so many shout outs. Thanks for watching, everybody. And that was a great question, Ava, about the thing on my guitar. This is a little tuner. If my guitar goes out of tune, I turn this thing on and it tells me if I'm playing the right note. It says E if I'm playing the E string, or B if I'm playing the B string, or G if I'm playing the G. It's pretty cool, and so it helps me know if the strings are in tune. It uses the vibrations, because when I play a string, the string vibrates, and that vibrations goes all through the body of the guitar, and this little machine reads the vibrations. So that's my tuner. Great question. Good observing. You're very observant to see that. Well, should we see another critter? I think that's a great idea. Let's see what other critters came along today. Ooh, it's my friend JJ. JJ the bird. You haven't seen JJ very many times. He's only come out once or twice before on my homespun shows. So let's call out JJ and see what he's up to. Everybody say, come on out, JJ. Come on out, JJ. Here I come. Hi, everybody. Nanny, nanny, boo, boo. You can't catch me. Hey, JJ, why do you say that? Because it's true, I'm so fast, you can't catch me. Nanny, nanny, boo, boo, you can't catch me. Hey, wait a minute, JJ. I don't really like that when somebody says, nanny, nanny, boo, boo, you can't catch me. That feels kind of like teasing. Oh, no, we're just playing a game, Red Yarn. I wasn't trying to tease. Don't take it personally. Nanny, nanny, boo, boo. Hey. JJ Bird, come on, be kind. What do y'all think? Does that sound like teasing to you? Raise your hand if that sounds like teasing. That sounds like teasing to me too. And teasing hurts people's feelings. Oh, I was just having fun, Red Yarn. You don't gotta get all bent out of shape about it. JJ Bird, come on. You know, it's okay to have fun, and sometimes we play games where we're a little bit sassy with each other, but sometimes you can take it too far and it starts to hurt people's feelings. Oh, well, I didn't mean to hurt your feelings. Well, then what do you say? Sorry about that, Red Yarn. It's okay, JJ. I know you weren't trying to hurt anybody's feelings. It's just important to be conscious of what you're saying and how it might come off to other people. Can you think of something else besides nanny, nanny, boo, boo that you could say if you wanted to play chase? Hey, do y'all want to play a game of chase or tag?
You do? That's so cool. If I fly up in the air, do you think you'd catch me? Let's try. Stand up, stand up. Okay, I'm gonna fly and see if you can jump up and touch. Okay, here we go. Oh, can you get me? Can you get me? Oh, this is so fun. Have you caught me yet? Oh, I'm a little too high. Oh, this is a great game. Y'all are so fast and so strong. Keep on jumping. Keep on flying. Y'all are the best. Bye, friends.
Say bye, JJ.
Bye.
Oh, that was a much nicer way for JJ to ask if y'all wanted to play chase or play tag. Just asking and not saying teasing kind of words. Hey, we're gonna sing a song about a bird, about a mockingbird. On this song, I'm gonna play on this thing. Do you know what that is? What do you call this? That's a harmonica, right? And I wear it on this little rack so I don't have to hold it in my hands while I play. If you have a harmonica at home and it's easy to get, you can go grab it and you can try to play along on your harmonica while I play this song. So I'm gonna play the harmonica and the guitar at the same time. And I'm gonna sing this song called Mockingbird. Now this song's got a lot of original words, words that I wrote, but it's based on a few old folk songs. The Mockingbird song, hush little baby, don't say a word. Mama's gonna buy you a mockingbird. You ever heard that song? Yeah, that's a sweet old traditional folk song. And also a old black folk song called Hambone. Hambone, Hambone, have you heard? So it's kind of based on both of those songs, but it's got some new words too. So if y'all want to stand up, flap your wings, dance around, this is a good dancing song. Here we go. A one, a two, a three, four.
Run, 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 do run, run. Do what did he
much, friends. Thanks for singing and dancing along. That was great. All right, we're going to do things in a slightly different order today. We're going to do a couple of critter portraits right now, and then we're going to do a little birthday shout out right after that. So everybody, hold tight.
Critter time, portrait time, critter portrait time, critter share portrait.
All right, we've got a couple of beautiful critter portraits to show off today. Are y'all ready to see them? Here they are. First, my friend Connolly did this beautiful, colorful painting. Actually, it looks like Connolly. Did you use several different materials to make this portrait? It looks, I think I see some paints or markers, but then maybe also I see some oil pastels. It looks like maybe you used a few different things. I'd be so curious to hear what you used to make this colorful portrait. This is Red Yarn sitting on a blue dinosaur teeter-totter with Max the Cat, Molly Cottontail, and Shiloh Squirrel playing nearby. I see Red Yarn, I see my glasses and my red beard, I see that big blue teeter-totter, and then I see the critters down below, the yellow critters, Max, Molly, and Shiloh. Oops, I didn't show it to y'all. Sorry, everybody. Thanks for your patience. Here we go. This is what I've been describing as Ms. Connolly's beautiful critter portrait. Sorry, I forgot to switch over to it. Anyways, this is what I was talking about. Y'all see it? Oh my gosh, I'm just, what am I doing? And here we've got another one. This is Nora and Zoe. Nora had made this frog puppet for school, and she put it on, and then they decided they should have a puppet show and sing that old folk song, Froggy Went A-Courtin'. So this is Nora and Zoe with their puppets singing Froggy Went A-Courtin'. Looks like Nora's also got a cool luge ukulele, and it looks like Zoe's got a bunny rabbit puppet too. This is so fun. What a great idea. And those paper bag puppets y'all made are so beautiful. Thank you for sharing. Can everybody give a big round of applause to Connolly? Let's see that again, since you didn't get to see it for very long before. And Nora and Zoe. Woohoo! So much fun, friends. Thank you for sharing your critter portraits with me. All right, here we go, friends. Sorry, I'm having a little bit of trouble today. Let's get back to where we were. So many things to click on. All right, here we go. And we also have a special birthday shout out today. I didn't have time to pull out my sign, but I want to wish happy birthday to my buddy Kian, who's turning 3 years old. Three, can everybody hold up three big fingers for Kian's third birthday? Woohoo! Happy third birthday, Kian. Can everybody sing happy birthday to Kian with me? Good, let's do it all together. Here we go. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Kian. Happy birthday to you. Woohoo! Happy birthday, Kian. I hope you had a great one. And thanks again to our critter portrait artists for sending in your artwork today. If you have any artwork you've been working on at home that you'd like me to show off on my show, you can have your grown-up send that to me over Facebook Messenger or email it to me at redyarnproductions@gmail.com. And same goes for birthday shout-outs. If you've got a birthday coming up or someone in your family does or a good friend does and you'd like to give them a birthday shout-out, send me a message here on Facebook or over on to my email, and I'll make sure to include you in my birthday shout-outs. Thanks so much, friends. Should we see another critter? I think that's a great idea. Let's see. Oh, it's my old buddy Rocky the Raccoon. Let's call out Rocky the Raccoon in a big voice. Everybody say, come on out, Rocky. Come on out, Rocky. Oh, here I come. Hey, everybody, it's me, Rocky Raccoon. What's the matter, Rocky? I'm just so bored. What do you mean you're bored, Rocky? Well, I've been sitting around my treehouse, it feels like for months and months, and I'm just getting so bored. I don't have anything fun to do. Wait a minute, Rocky. You know, you can always come up with new fun stuff to do. Well, I've tried everything I could think of. I've read all the books, I've played all the board games, I've said hi to all my friends, and now there's nothing left to do. I'm bored, bored, bored. Oh, Rocky. Raise your hand if y'all ever feel bored. I feel bored sometimes, too. It's natural to feel bored. But you know what's a good thing to do when you're feeling bored? What's that? Well, let your mind start flowing, get your creativity going, and see if you can think of something fun to do. Do y'all have any fun suggestions for what Rocky could do when he's feeling bored? Oh, I'd love to see your suggestions. If you got any ideas, have your grown-ups type them into the little comments, okay? So I can get some good ideas about what to do. Do you got any ideas for me, Red Yarn? Well, if I'm feeling bored, I love going on a little walk around the neighborhood. I love going on a bike ride. I love looking through my bookshelf and finding a book I haven't read in a long time, picking that up. Maybe calling a friend or getting a friend on video chat and saying hello. Sometimes I like to sit down and try to write a new song. I pick up my guitar. I start playing my guitar. There's so many great things you can do when you're feeling bored. Well, those are such fun ideas. Thanks for your suggestions, y'all. And I can't wait to see what other ideas you have for me, okay? Thanks for helping me not be so bored. I'm gonna go read a book. No. I'm gonna go write a song. No. I'm gonna go take a walk. Oh, there's so much to do. I don't even know where to begin. Thanks for your ideas, friends. Bye. Say bye, Rocky. Bye. All right, y'all. Thanks for helping Rocky come up with some ideas about what he can do. We're gonna sing a song real quick. I gotta grab another tool. And then we're going to sing a song about fun things you can do in your own backyard. This song is called My Own Backyard. This is a new song off my most recent record, Backyard Bop. And it's kind of based on my childhood and things I like to do in my backyard when I was a kid. Now, I know not everybody has a backyard. Not everybody lives in a house with a backyard. Some people live in apartments. Maybe you have a courtyard at your apartment or a park you can go to nearby. Some people live in a house, but there's not a backyard, there's just a front yard. Some people live in a building where there's really just kind of a front stoop and a sidewalk out front. So you don't have to have a backyard to think of fun, creative things to do outside. But this song's called My Own Backyard. Here's how it goes. Thanks for listening, y'all. I'd love to hear about the adventures you've been having in your backyard, at the neighborhood park, at whatever spaces you like playing in. Hopefully we can all get a little more sunshiny weather so we can have some more outdoor adventures before it gets too wintry. We're in the middle of a beautiful week here in Portland, Oregon, so I hope you all can get outside and have some fun this week. All right, let's see if I missed any shout-outs. Ooh, Ava said that's a cool story about the tuner. Thanks again for asking about that. Oh, good, Kian and Kai were watching. Happy birthday, Kian. Yep, thanks, sorry about the pictures. And some more happy birthdays. Ooh, well, you had a few cool ideas if you're feeling bored. Deborah's family suggested that you can make a paper airplane. Have y'all ever made a paper airplane before? It's so cool. Ask your grown-up if they can help. Just get a piece of paper, and if you fold it in a certain way, you can make a cool airplane that can fly across the room. If you're with siblings or with friends, you can each make one and have a little contest to see who can fly theirs the farthest or decorate them the most creatively. Those are great ideas. Nora suggested that Rocky could play with Legos. That's a great idea. We do have some Legos. My kiddos love playing Legos. Oh, that's so cool. And Royal, my nephew who's watching, hi Royal, has been going to the park to see the goldfish, the hawks, and the peacocks. That's so cool if you've got a park nearby where you can go cool, see cool stuff like that. Thanks for the great ideas, y'all. Hey, we're gonna sing one more song today, okay? This is a sweet old African-American folk song called Mr. Rabbit, and I was hoping you could help me sing it. Can you hold out your finger like this? Can you point all around and imagine you're pointing at every soul in your whole community, all around your neighborhood, all around the country, every sweet living person in the whole wide world. And we're going to dedicate this song to them. It goes like this. Every little soul is going to shine, shine, shine. Every little soul is going to shine, shine, shine. You want to sit and relax, tap the beat on your knees, sing along. Here's how it goes. Oh, Mr. Rabbit, Mr. Rabbit, why you're here so long? Yes, so he is, he was put on wrong. Every little soul is going to shine, shine, shine. Every little soul is gonna shine, shine. Next one says, Mr. Rabbit, Mr. Rabbit, why is your coat so gray? Yes, oh yes, it was made that way. Here's how it goes. Oh, Mr. Rabbit, Mr. Rabbit, why is your coat so gray? Yes, oh yes, it was made that way. Every little soul is gonna shine, shine, shine. Every little soul is gonna shine, shine, shine. How about Mr. Rabbit, Mr. Rabbit, what do you eat? Carrots and cabbage from my head to my feet. Oh, Mr. Rabbit, Mr. Rabbit, what do you eat? Carrots and cabbage from my head to my feet. Soul is gonna shine, shine, shine. Every little soul is gonna shine, shine, shine. How about one more? Mr. Rabbit, Mr. Rabbit, why is your tail so white? Yes, oh yes, I'm getting out of sight. Here it is. Oh, Mr. Rabbit, Mr. Rabbit, why is your tail so white? Yes, oh yes, I'm getting out of sight. Every little soul is gonna shine, shine, shine. Every little soul is gonna shine, shine, shine. Keep on making them shine. It's gonna shine. Oh, it's gonna shine, shine, shine. Oh, it's gonna shine. Thanks for letting it shine so bright today. Friends, it was so good to see you all this morning. Thanks for tuning in. Thanks for coming and rambling with us today. It was so great to see you. I'm Red Yarn. I'm doing these Ramblin' with Red Yarn shows on Tuesday and Thursday mornings at 10 a.m. Pacific time. You can also watch them later on Facebook. You can replay them, or you can go to YouTube and check out reruns there. It usually takes me a few days, sometimes even a week, to get the old episodes up on YouTube, but you can go check them out there. And while you're at it, check out my new Red Yarn's Backyard series and the other music videos we got going. I so appreciate y'all tuning in. If your family's in a position to donate, you can do that on Venmo. That's at Red Yarn. Cash App is @RedYarn. There's a PayPal link in the Facebook post. Or you can support on an ongoing basis on Patreon, like a monthly donation. And my Patreon supporters get sneak peeks of my new videos and get to see other cool behind-the-scenes content, too. So thank you all so much who are in a position to donate for doing that. I want to give a big shout-out to my buddy Aaron Nigel Smith, who's working behind the scenes, running the cameras and the stream. He and I are sharing a cool studio space now. Check out the work he is doing. You can check out his YouTube page. He's got something called The Big Up Show. Check out his new live album, Live in LA. He's a good friend and a good buddy, and it's so great to be sharing space and working with him. Friends, we've got one more thing to do. We've got to say, see you later, alligator. So get your chompers out like this and repeat after me. See you later, alligator. See you later, alligator. After a while, crocodile. After a while, crocodile. See you later, alligator. See you later, alligator. After a while, crocodile. After a while, crocodile. Well, I really gotta go. Well, I really gotta go. Give me one more pretty smile. Give me one more pretty smile. Cheese. Having a high five for great singing and dancing today. A pat on the back for good listening and safe bodies, and a big hug for being such sweethearts. It was so good to ramble with y'all today. Thanks for tuning in. I'll see you on Thursday morning, okay? Have a great week. Bye, friends. See ya.